processing place.
It's quite bizarre, really. Here we are, 50 metres below the earth. Up above us, we've got this, you know, bustling metropolis. And down here, we've got this place where many people laboured for a long time to build this fantasy. It's really quite weird.
Well, it stinks down there. It's not a very healthy environment, and people are really stressed and speedy, and I become the same, but it's very convenient.
I think I'm probably the only ambassador in Paris who does regularly use the metro system, and I have an annual ticket even, so how about that? I find that I don't usually drive much in Paris because, although I don't mind driving, once you've driven somewhere, there's nowhere to park.
I mean, it's good because it's practical, and sometimes you do hear some amazing music down there, or you meet people, or you run into someone that you haven't seen for years. You run into them in the metro. Now, that's different. In Sydney, I never run into anyone I know on the train. I think everyone's got their heads down reading their paper on the way to work or on the way home, and you run into them maybe at the beach or at the pub.
After you are in the metro, the thing you're dreaming of is to go back to your house and to not move anymore.
It used to be, I think they've changed it now, they've probably redesigned it, but if you put your hand on the door as it was opening and left it there, your hand was jammed into the part of the train where the door goes in. And the only way of getting it out is they have to close the doors. So I just remember sort of in a panic having my fingers stuck in the door, waiting for the train for the doors to close and the train to go off again so I could take my hand out.
Have you always paid for your tickets?
Oh no, I must admit I wasn't a regular buyer of tickets. I needed to make some saving, and so it's easy to cheat.
In the 60s there used to be this special woman called a poinçonneuse who made a hole in your ticket and also opened a gate so you could get out onto the platform, and they were really sadistic, and when you saw somebody really running late for a metro, she with great glee would close the gate in front of you and you just have to wait there and see the metro go.
The normal life takes place in the metro, so it becomes the mirror of the society. And about that, many people are criticizing the metro. Yes, there are homeless, there are people who sing in the metro, there is some insecurity impression and so on. Okay, but that's life. Oh.
Nous sommes tous nés d'amour dans de vieux pays où seuls de vieux, de très vieux singes sont assis. Aux commandes de nos libertés, aux manettes de nos intégrités. Alors tapons-nous sur le nez, ça les fait toujours rigoler. Allez oui, tapons-nous entre nous, ça leur fera toujours de gros sous quand ils nous vendront des canis et des idées malsaines pour que nos petites vies s'enfouissent dans la violence et la haine. Alors quoi? On va coucher dehors, sous des ponts d'or que j'ai trop reconstruits pour aller de leur cuisine à leur living, living room. C'est pas du temps, c'est le living room des vieux singes savants, c'est le living, 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 living room.
In the year 2000,
Paris celebrated 100 years of the metro system. In fact, the RATP, the Paris Transport Authority, established an entire department to oversee the refurbishment of stations, to organise artworks, performances in the metro, and even publish a temporary metro newspaper. So popular, it's now a permanent fixture. This is not a history of the Paris metro system. I'm just going to use it to get around and meet some interesting people.
D'une envie de vivre, d'une envie de parcourir le monde, cette bonne terre si gironde. Mais non, voilà qu'on en gronde, car sans laisser passer, faut pas se laisser aller, arrêter d'une autre vie. Mon ami, non, 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 faut pas rêver, car pour rêver, faut des laisser passer du papier pour passer sa vie de l'autre côté du pont. Des ponts d'or dehors, y'en a des tonnes. C'est pas qu'on les ignore, car on les voit souvent passer de leur cuisine.